Hi, welcome to the truck.
Lots of stuff.
Appreciate your help.
What's that?
I appreciate your help. That's the back wall of a truck. It was the most satisfying thing to see when I worked at Walmart. And it's the most satisfying thing to see now. It's done. Truck number one, done. Yes, I know, Mini. I agree. Whoa.
Yeah, they get caught.
Where are you going, Min? Oh. They're going. Oh. It's just the wind, Minnie. It's okay. So looking back over all the clips that I filmed today, I realized there wasn't a lot. I didn't really film much. But all you really need to know is that Ryan and his parents came over. He helped us unload the rest of the truck. We hung out in the house for a while, and I got really sweaty because it's been really hot today and I've been moving a lot of stuff and I cannot wait to get out of these clothes. And then Ryan headed back to his hotel with his parents. We might be seeing him again, or them again, on, what day was it on? Friday, I think. So hopefully we'll get to interact with them on the vlog then as well. Now, you may have noticed, I kind of have a bit of furniture in here. My plan kind of changed a little bit. We've got the bed in here, right here. And originally I was going to have it in this corner, kind of coming out to here. I think I told you guys that last night. And I was going to have the futon at the end of it, and then over on that wall over there we would have the TV stand. Well, the futon ended up being far, far too close to the TV. Like, imagine how it is here, but like half that. Maybe more than half that. It was, maybe less than half of that. It was bad. The view would have been way too close to the TV. So instead, we put the bed right here, with the window right behind. And now, the problem is, can't quite see the TV from here. It's on a bit of an angle, but I can always, like, turn it a little bit. So that I can still watch stuff from the bed. And the thing that is up on the screen right there is something that Alyssa recommended that I watch called The Atom Project. I'm actually still signed into her Netflix, so probably gonna watch that. And we don't have everything up here yet, but the current idea, you know, we've got the desk here, we've got the futon there, so yeah, I think if I'm gonna probably try and put the TV on something, like maybe this crate. Because then I can actually see the TV from the desk if I want to. I don't know yet. I might not need that, but it's just an idea that I had. The Amiibo shelf is right behind the desk, where it needs to be, because I want to have the same background that I had at the old place. And then we have this other shelf up here, and then the CD one is in the corner. That might move. I just kind of wanted to get some stuff up here. We don't have the Billies up here yet. I have four Billy bookcases, three of which have extension units. Honestly, I'm probably going to put them, or at least three of them, right here. Three Billies right on this wall. I think that'll look pretty nice. And then I also have the half-size Billy, and I have the bigger unit that my printer and my record player go on. So, I don't know where those would go. I might just have to not have that one up here, but we'll see. Yeah, that's going to be probably what's happening tomorrow. My parents are out in the morning. They're going to go get their new their Florida licenses. But I'm hoping whenever they get back, my dad can help me like carry the Billy bookcases up here. Because I just want to have the furniture in place. I want to know where everything's going to be. So I can feel better about myself. Or something like that. So that is the current plan. And also, the Ethernet port is there, up on the wall, so I don't want to really put anything in front of it. So if I can, I'm going to try and avoid doing that, and I'll just have that bit of wall, this bit of wall right here, free, so that the Ethernet cord can just come right on down there. I have ordered a network splitter today, as well as a 5-pack of Ethernet cords, and a LAN adapter for my Switch, so really, really hoping that those arrive before the Mario Kart stuff comes out, so that I can actually record that for this weekend. But we'll see what happens. For right now, I'm going to lay in bed and watch The Atom Project, and I will catch up with you afterwards and tell you what I think. So I really enjoyed it. Also, I got hot, so I took my shirt off, and then I got cold. So now I'm under the blanket. Whatever. Yeah, really good. Really, really enjoyable movie. Honestly, so some parts of it were a little predictable. It is a time travel story. But I kind of like that. I'm a fan of time travel stories, especially when they're done well. And I think that this one was pretty good. I don't want to spoil anything, but seeing future, past and future versions of characters interacting with each other is something that I always like in my stories and my time travel stories. And that's basically this entire movie. So, oh God. Definitely check it out if you have if you have Netflix. And also just a super wholesome ending. I'm always a fan of a wholesome ending, if it can make me feel happy inside. And sure enough, this did. So, very good. Definitely check out The Adam Project on Netflix. But for now, that's going to be it for today. I'm going to go to sleep. So thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then.